Hello everyone, this is Zaida Ghulami from AgriMedSafe Research Company, and in today's video, I'm going to teach you how to subtract dates in Excel. So basically, you can use a date difference or date diff function in Excel, which you can see is not found in the list of functions, okay? The cause is that it has some errors and it makes some mistakes, and because of that, Excel doesn't list date diff function as diff functions in Excel, but you still can use it with some considerations. Let's see how it works. So I have two dates in here. The first date you use should be the starting date, okay? So we started from 18th day of month number 5, and we got to month number 8. So the starting date, the ending date, and now I want to have the days in here. So I close the parentheses. And if you get a result like that, it's because you should go to format cells and get a number in category. Click OK and you can see I have 92 days between these two dates. You can use the same function for the number of years. So starting date, ending date, and year. It's zero because you don't have any complete years between these two dates. I can use it also for months, starting, ending, and month. You can see I have 3 months in between. So let's get into another example. The first day of first month of 2016, and I have day of fifth month of 2018. So starting date, ending date, and year month with this function. So what it gets is the number of months that you have from the last complete year in your selection. So let's count together. We have 2016 and we have passed the whole year, okay? We got to 2017 and we had it complete also. Now we get to 2018. We have month number 1, 2, 3, 4 completed and 5 not completed yet. So we have 4 months until the last completed year. The support page of Excel recommends not using this function for month date because of the before mentioned, you know, problems that this function had. But you can, for example, you can use this function year with year month argument along with the same function and years argument. What it gets you is the exact year month difference between these two dates. So you have 2 years, 2 complete years, and 4 complete months between these two dates. But another, you know, simple way to subtract dates is to use the normal subtract function. So what you will do is to select the nearest date, you subtract, and then select the starting point. Now what it gets you is the exact output of the function. So you have 92 days. Now you can divide the result by 7 to get the number of weeks. Of course, we want to have it with no decimals. So again, you can divide it by 30 to get the number of months, the exact result of that, or by 364 to get 0 years. So that was just an alternative maybe for date difference to see whether you can use it when date diff does not work properly. So that's it for today's video. I hope you learned something new. Please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to Techniques Up channel. I will see you in the next video, and bye.